So this is the picture of General Assembly of United Nations. Now these are some of the characteristics, which is, it is the biggest organ of the United Nations. In the entire United Nations, this General Assembly is considered to be a biggest organ. The second is every member of the world. Now, in the world, there are 198 nations, and almost every nation is a part of the United Nations General Assembly and discuss, advise, and suggest any matter. Now, whenever there is any matter at an international level, all the leaders of the world meet there once in a year and they discuss, suggest, and advice regarding any matter. The headquarters are located in the New York City of America country. These are some of the important characteristics of the General Assembly. Second is Security Council. Here is a chart of one of the veto power which is used by the various nations. Now, veto power is anything which these permanent nations can use at any time in the Security General Assembly of the United Nations to stop any legal actions. In simple words, it means these nations which are depicted in the chart can say no when the world nation members are agreeing, and these nations have some power which are known as veto power. It means they can stop any kind of legislation at any point of the time in United Nations. The characteristics are five permanent nations who can do the veto power in the United Nations General Assembly. These permanent nations are France, America, Russia, China, and Britain. It means they only are having the power in the United Nations General Assembly, which whenever they can say at any point of the legislation no to pass any kind of the decision. It means the veto power is having with these five permanent nations. Next is enjoy tremendous powers. Because they are having the veto powers, they are considered to be the powerful countries in compared to the other countries. So these nations enjoy tremendous powers. It means they are having very much powers as compared to other nations who do not have veto powers. Third is it solves the problems of United Nations through negotiations and mediations. And whenever there is arising any kind of problem, these nations solve these problems peacefully through the negotiations and mediations. They act as the mediators to solve any problem arises in the world. The organizations are FAO, that is Food and Agricultural Organization, which provides food security to the citizens of the world. The second is ILO, it is International Labour Organizations, protects the rights and the labors in the world regarding the labor and another kind of the wages, that they should get the minimum amount of the wages by working at any place. Third is UNICEF, that is United Nations International Child Education Fund, which provides fund to the children for their food, basic necessities, education, and various other activities which are necessary for the nurturing of the child. The fourth is UNESCO, that is United Nations Education Scientific Cultural Organization, which provides the educational and scientific and cultural platform to the citizens of the world by protecting them and encourage the scientific discovery, inventions, protects the cultures and develop the relations of human beings. This includes mandate the nations who haven't got independence. Those nations which haven't got independence, so there are five permanent nations which decides the independence of the nations which haven't got the independence. So it is the fourth, known as the Trusteeship Council of the United Nations body. Judges are appointed for a period of 9 years. Now, unlike there is Supreme Court in India, this is an International Court of Justice, so it settles the disputes between the nations which are having the disputes between them. And the headquarters are located in the Hague city of Netherlands. So this is only the Supreme, which is known as the International Court of Justice, whose headquarters are only located outside USA, that is in the European continent. It is the office of the Secretary Council. Now, Secretary is a person who is handling the United Nations, these number of the organs what we have discussed, and the office is known as the Secretariat. And United Nations always maintains the world peace, world unity and the brotherhood kind of the feeling among the nations of the world. Thank you, students. Have a nice day.